morning to all of you. Now we are going to see the basic concepts of the initial chapters, which maybe you have missed out. So I'm starting with the basics of artificial intelligence. Now we are going to start with introduction, means how this subject has introduced or what how it is related to. So Homo sapiens means man, and how the man is intelligent, how the man is wise, and that is connected with the machine, and that is known as artificial intelligence. So how the man is going to think, how it is going to understand, how it is going to predict, and how it is going to manipulate the things, and these all are related to the machines, and that machine is called as artificial intelligence. So the man's intelligence, it is connected with the machine, and it is going to define the term as artificial intelligence. So the features which present in the man's mind or in the man's brain, that all are applied in the artificial intelligence. So it attempts not to understand but also to build intelligent entities. Now the work for this artificial intelligence has already started in 1965. Now where we can use this artificial intelligence for playing the games, for solving the mathematical equations, or for driving the cars. Already Google has trying out for the driving car also by using artificial intelligence. Now when we thought that we want to apply the what are the presence in the human mind or a brain that we want to apply to a machine, then we have to differentiate between a man and a machine. So what the things we have to give to the man, to the machine, which are in the man. So think humanly, that means how the woman is going to think, that is we have to apply to a machine. Think rationally, how the man is thinking positively, that we want to apply to a machine. Act humanly, how the human behaves, that we have to apply to a machine, for example robotics. And act rationally means always you have to act in a positive way. So that is called as AI. So the definition on the top of the concern is processing and reasoning. How the man brain is processed and how it is going to give the reasoning, that we have to apply to a machine. Always the man can think in either a positive or negative direction. But when we think rationally, means we have to think always in a positive direction or a positive way, and that we have to apply to a machine. So a system is rational if it does the right thing what it knows. Next we are talking about the Turing machine or Turing test approach, acting humanly, that is acting humanly. Turing test proposed, that is Alan Turing, was designed to provide a satisfactory operational definition of intelligence. Turing defined intelligence behavior as the ability to achieve human level performance in all cognitive tasks sufficient to fool an interrogator. It means that the machine should behave or act in such a way that it should have the ability to achieve the human level performance. Means the machine should perform as a human being or as a human level. He proposed that the computer should be interrogated by a human via the teletype and passes the test if the interrogator cannot tell if there is a computer or a human at the end. It means he proposed one test, and it should be interrogated, the computer should be interrogated by human or a teletype, and the interrogator should not understand whether the answer will be from the machine or from the human being. The computer would need to possess the following capabilities. Natural language processing, means suppose I don't want to differentiate between human and a computer, then whatever the things available with a human being or with a human brain, that we want to apply to a machine also. And the number one comes as a natural language processing. So what is the language we are speaking naturally, that should be understood or that should be convenient to a machine also. So the natural language processing to enable it to communicate sufficiently in English. Knowledge representation, to store information provided before or during the interrogator. It means the particular knowledge is given to a machine, and that based on the knowledge, the machine should answer the questions. Automated reasoning, to use the stored information to answer the question and to draw the new conclusions. The reasoning ability or the feedback of the reasoning should be provided to a machine, so the automated reasoning should be done from the machine side. The machine learning to adapt a new circumstances and detect and extrapolate patterns. So the machine learning approach should be also given to a machine so that it should not be identified from the human being. So these are the four capabilities we need. So whenever we want to design any artificial intelligence machine, we need at least these four capabilities. Number one, natural language processing, knowledge representation, automated reasoning, and machine learning. Now, next, that is total Turing test. Now, total Turing test includes a video signals also, so that interrogator can test the subject's perceptual abilities as well as the opportunities for the interrogator to pass the physical object through the hatch. To pass the total Turing test, the computer needs computer vision. Means here, in case of Turing test and in case of total Turing test, there is a difference. In case of total Turing test, the computer vision is provided extra. Robotics to manipulate objects and move about. So it includes in the total Turing test. Second, acting humanly, the cognitive modeling approach. If we are going to say that the given program think like a human, we must have some way to determine how the human thinks. So if you want to apply the thinking level of a human to a machine, then we have to first thought that how the human is thinking or what are the steps he is following. We need to get inside the actual working of a human brain. There are three ways to do this. Through the introspection, we can introspect, through the psychological experiments, and through the brain imagining. Now, once we have a sufficient precise theory of the mind, we can express the theories, and that is we want to apply to a computer program. The interdisciplinary field of cognitive science brings together computer models from the AI and experimental techniques from psychology to construct precise and testable theories of the human mind. That means thinking humanly means how the human is thinking, and that approach we have to apply to a machine. Now, thinking rationally means always in the positive direction, the loss of thought approach. Now, the Greek philosopher Aristotle was one of the first to attempt to codify right thinking. So right thinking has been designed or codified by Aristotle. His syllogism provided a pattern for argument structure that always yield the correct conclusion when given the correct premise. For example, Socrates is a man and all men are mortal, therefore Socrates is a mortal. So this is a kind of syllogism. So in a syllogism direction, we can apply a logic. So these laws of thought were supposed to govern the operation of the mind, and the study is initiated the field of called logic. Logicians in the 19th century developed a precise notation for statement about all kinds of objects in the world and relation among them. Now, there are two main obstacles to this approach. That is, it is not easy to take the informal language and state in it the formal terms required by logical notion, particularly when the knowledge is less than 100%. Second is, there is a big difference between solving a problem in practice. And that is in principle and in practice. So even problems with just a few hundred facts can exhaust the computational resources of any computer unless it has some guidance as to which reasoning steps to try first. Now, the next point is acting rationally, the rational agent approach. The agent is just something that acts. That means the agent is nothing but who is going to act, that is called as agent. A rational agent is one that acts as to achieve the best outcome or when there is uncertainty, the best expected outcome. So acting rationally or the rational agent means the agent or which is going to act, but in such a manner that it is going to provide the best outcome or the best result. So the making correct inference is sometimes part of being a rational agent, because one way to act rationally is to reason logically to be a conclusion that a given action will achieve one's goal and act on the conclusion. So on the other hand, correct inference is not all the rationally in some situations. There is no probably correct things to do, but something must still be done. There are also ways of acting rationally that cannot be said to involve inference. All the skills needed for the Turing test also allows an agent to act rationally. Knowledge, representation, and reasoning enable agents to reach good decisions. Now, one important point to keep in mind, we will see before too long that achieving perfect rationally, always doing the right thing, is not feasible in complex environment. It means the right thing is called as rational agent, but in some situations, it is not always the right thing. Next, that the foundation of artificial intelligence. Now, some basic subjects are there. Based on these subjects, the artificial intelligence has arrived. One, that is philosophy. That can formal rules be used to draw the valid conclusions? How does the mind arise from the physical brain? And where does knowledge come from? So, from the philosophy point of view, we have to think and we have to apply these answers to a machine. How does knowledge lead to an action? From the mathematics, we have to see or we have to apply these questions and we have to apply the answers. What are the formal rules to draw the valid conclusion? How can be computed? And how does we reason with uncertain information? From the economics point of view, we can apply these questions. How should we make decisions so as to maximize the payroll? How should we do when the others may go along? So these are the questions from economics. And this is the structure of the neuron from the brain, how the sensor is going to work. So this is a kind of biological kind of structure where the neurons pass the sensors pass the information, and it is going to think and it is going to reply for the answer. From the neuroscience, how do the brain process information? From the psychology point of view, how do human and animals think and act? And from computer engineering part, we have to build efficient computer. So these are the basic formulations of the subjects based on which the artificial intelligence has arrived. How can artifacts operate under their own control? So this is from the control system. From the linguistic, which language or how does the language is related or how the language is applied for the AI? Next, we are talking about the history of the artificial intelligence. Now, this is the kind of history, means how it is started, how it is developed, or how it is evolved, and till date, what did the process is. So, this was the end of the chapter. So, this was a very basic chapter. In the next session, we will see the basic of the next chapter. Now, we will see the state of the art, means what are the applications of the artificial intelligence. First, that is a robotic vehicle. We have used or we have started working on the robotic vehicles, speech recognition, autonomous planning and scheduling, game playing, spam fighting. So these are some of the applications which are called a structure of the artificial intelligence. Now we are talking about the intelligent agent. So this was from the next chapters. Now, the agent and environment. Already we have seen the diagram. This is an environment from where we have to pass the percepts. From the percepts, for the agent should act rationally. So for the agent, input is given from the sensors and output is given via the actuator, and the particular actions performed to again for the environment. So an agent is anything that can be viewed as perceiving its environment through the sensors and acting upon upon that environment through the actuators. Human agent are eye, ear and other organs for sensors, and hand, legs, vocal tract, so on. These are the actuators. So sensors are nothing but which are sensing, for example, eye, ear, these are organs which are going to sense it. So these are called as sensors, and the legs, hands, these are going to act it, so that these are called actuators. And that the same concept we have applied in the agent and environment. A robotic agent might have a cameras and infrared range finders for sensors and various motors for actuators. A software agent receives keystrokes, file content, and network packets as sensory inputs and acts on the environment by displaying on the screen, writing files, and sending network packets. So from the robotic agent, what are the sensors or what are the actuators and what are the sensors? We can classify it. We use the term percept to refer to the agent perceptual input at any given instance. An agent's percept sequence is the complete history of anything that the agent has ever perceived. It means if a particular task is given to agent, now what are steps it is going to follow? This history is nothing but percept sequence. So the agent choice of action at any given instance can depend on the entire percept sequence observed to date, but not anything that hasn't perceived. By specifying the agent's choice of action for every possible percept sequence, we have said more or less anything there is to say about the agent. So mathematically, we say that the agent's behavior is described by the agent function that maps any given percept sequence to an action. So for example, suppose I want to make the addition of the two variables, then I have to take the input of the two variables. So we have to define c is equal to a plus b. So we have to write a function. That function is nothing but agent function that ordered the task. And that sequence of taking the variables and giving the output, that is called as percept sequence. Now we can imagine tabulating the agent function that describes any given agent for most agent. This would be a very large table, infinite in fact, unless we place a bound on the length of the percept sequence we consider. That means the percept sequence can be infinite, so we have to make the boundaries or the length should be defined for the percept sequence. Given an agent to experiment with, we can construct this table by trying out all possible percept sequence and recording which actions the agent does in response. The table is of course an external characterization of the agent. Internally, the agent function for an artificial agent will be implemented by the agent program. It is important to keep these two ideas distinct or separate. The agent function is abstract mathematical description and the agent program is a concrete implementation. So agent function is nothing but we have to define the function or we have to describe the function, but agent program is nothing but its actual implementation of the program or the function. Now here is the example of the vacuum cleaner. Now A and clean. So from the block A, we have to clean because in the block there is a garbage. Again, the direction we have to take, that's we have to go in the to B, that is for the right direction. If A has a dirty block, we have to suck it. If B has a dirt clean, then we have to go at the left, that is at the A block. If the B block is a dirty, we have to suck it. That means whenever the block is dirty, we have to suck it. If whenever the block is clean, we have to go at the right or left depending on the position. Now it has two just locations, square A and square B. So this is again the same information which I have described previously. The vacuum agent perceives which square it is and whether there is a dirt in the sequence. So if there is a dirt, it is going to suck it, otherwise it is going to go in the left or right direction. Now the good behavior. The rational agent is one that does the right thing conceptually. It means the agent is rational if it is going in a right direction or if it is going in a positive way, it is called as good behavior. So every entry in the table for the agent function is filled out correctly. When agent is plucked out in the environment, it generates a sequence of actions according to the percept it receives. This sequence of actions causes the environment to go through a sequence of states. If the sequence is desirable, then the agent has performed well. This notion of desirability is captured by a performance measure that evaluates any given sequence of the environment states. Now we are talking about the rationality. Rationality depends on the four things: the performance measure that defines the criteria of the success, the agent's prior knowledge of the environment, the actions that the agent can perform, and the agent's percept sequence to date. So these are the four things where the rationality depends on the performance, depends on the knowledge, depends on the the agent's performance, the action, and last, that's the sequence or the percept sequence. Now this leads to the definition of the rational agent. For each possible percept sequence, a rational agent should select an action that is expected to maximize its performance measure given the evidence provided by the percept sequence and whatever built-in knowledge the agent has. Now we have taken the example of the vacuum cleaner. We can tabularize the example. So either he had to go left, right or suck. So these are the three actions he has available or the agent has available. Next, that's omniscience, learning and autonomy. So these are the concepts we have to apply to artificial intelligence. Now omniscience means what? It omniscience agent is the actual outcome of the action. So omniscience means what will be the actual outcome of the agent, that is called as omniscience. And it may be from the learning. Next, we are talking about the learning. So always from the in feedback or always from the output, the machine should learn, that is called as machine learning. And autonomy. Autonomy means the machine should take the independent decisions, that is called as autonomy. So our definition requires a rational agent not only to gather information but also to learn as much as possible for what it perceives. Now the autonomy. Autonomy means it has to take the independent decision, that is called as autonomy. Now next, that is specifying the task environment. It comes from the nature of the environment. Now we must think about the task environment, which are essentially the problems to which the rational agent are the solutions. So here we are talking about the what will be the nature of the environment. From the environment we are giving the inputs, and to the environment we are receiving in outputs again. Now here we have to call, that is PES, depends on the PES, that is performance, environment, actuator and sensor. So already we have seen this, the performance, environment, actuator and sensor. We have taken an example of taxi driver. Now what will be the performance, means how the performance is measured, if it is safe, if it is fast, if it is legal, if it is comfort, if it is it has maximum profit, the performance can be measured. What are the environments then? For the taxi driver, I want to make the automation of the taxi driving by using artificial intelligence. Then these are the inputs we have to take into consideration. So for the environment, we have to take consideration of roads, traffic or the customers. From the actuators, what are the parameters? The steering, accelerator, brake, signal. From the sensors, we can get the input from the camera or from the GPS, from the accelerometer. So here we have to divide into PAS. P means performance, E means environment, A means actuator and S means sensor. So this is one example we have taken it. So to maximize the profit, where we have to concentrate, that the example we have taken. Now we have to talk about the structure of the problems. Now the job of the artificial intelligence too is to define the agent program. So always the agent receives the input. In the agent we have to process it and we have to give the output via the actuator. So always we have to concentrate on the agent, and that is called as agent program. So in the architecture we have to concentrate first on the agent. So agent is nothing but its architecture and the program. Now what will be the agent program? The agent program that all have the same skeleton. They take the current percept as input from the sensor and return action to the actuator, that is called as output. The difference between agent program, which takes the current percept as input, and the agent function, which takes the entire percept history. The agent program takes just the current percept as input because nothing more is available from the environment. If the agent's action need to depend on the entire percept sequence, the agent will have to remember the percept. Now figure shows the travel agent program that keeps track of the percept sequence and then uses it to index into a table of actions to decide what to do. Now this is the algorithm for the table driven agent. Percept is the input and the return will be the action. So the sequence we have to pass and what will be the action, that will be the output. Now here we have written function for the reflex vacuum cleaner agent. So if the status is a dirty, then we have to suck it. If the location A, then we have to go to right. If the location is B, we have to go at the left. Then there are four types of reflex agents. We are going to talk on this reflex agent. First, that's a simple reflex agent. Now, the simplest reflex agent, the simplest kind of reflex agent are those agents where the actions are the basis of the current percept, ignoring the rest of the history. So, in the simple reflex agent, the history is not going to take into consideration. Only the current situation or only the current action is going to take into consideration. The example we have taken, that is a vacuum cleaner or the vacuum agent, whose agent function is tabulated into figure. So this is the environment, and this is the sensor, this is the actuator, and this is the entire agent. From the environment, we are giving the input to the sensor. The sensor is going to manipulate all the information, and the result will be carried out by the actuator, and this output or the result is giving again to the environment. And this is the algorithm for the simple reflex agent. Next, that is model-based reflex agent. Now, in the model-based reflex agent, we have to take consideration of the percept history. Now, this is the example and the algorithm of the model-based reflex agent. From the sensors, we have to take the history, that is state, how the world evolves, what are the actions previously, and what are the action condition rules. So, this is history, we have to take it into consideration, and after that, the output will be decided and given by the actuator, via actuator. So, this is the model-based reflex agent. And this is the algorithm for the model-based reflex agent. The percept is the input, return is an action, state that is going to define, rule match that is going to define, and action that is going to define it. Next, that is goal-based agent. Now, in the goal-based agent, the particular target is given, and based on the target, we have to check whether the goal has achieved or not. So, the particular goal information that describes the situation are desirable. So, the goal information is already given, and we have to check whether the particular goal has achieved or not. Next, utility-based agent. Utilities are nothing but services. A particular service is assigned to an agent, and we have to check whether the particular utility or service has done or not. So that is called as utility-based agent. An agent's utility function is essentially an internalization of the performance measure. If the internal utility function and external performance measure are in agreement, then agents that chooses action to maximize its utility will be rational according to external performance measure. So, in case of utility agent, the particular utility function is defined. In the particular utility function, we have to define what all the agreements or on what basis we have to measure the performance, and we have to check whether that particular agreement is fulfilled or not. Next, we are checking the learning agents. Now, this is the basic block diagram for the learning agent. Now, for the learning agent, there will be a critic where the criticize has been done. Learning element should be there, and the performance measurement should be there. There should be a problem generator. Now, if there is a change, then the change should be reflected in the performance measure. If there is a particular knowledge, based on the knowledge, the learning agent is going to learn. A learning agent can be divided into four conceptual components, as shown in the previous figure. The most important, that is the learning element, which is responsible for making improvement, and the performance element, which is responsible for selecting external actions. The performance element is what we have previously considered to be the entire agent. It takes in percept and decides an action. The learning element uses the feedback from the critic on how the agent is doing, and it determines how the performance element should be modified to be a better in future. Now, the critic tells the learning element how well the agent is doing with respect to the fixed performance standards. So, there should be some performance standards, and the critic tells whether it is below the performance or above the performance or equal performance. There should be a program generator that is the last component. Now it is responsible for suggesting the actions that will lead to a new and informative experiences. The point is that if the performance element has its way, it would keep doing the actions are the best given what it knows. Next, we are talking about how the components is of the agent of the program, how the component of a agent program is going to work. Now we are going to talk about the how these components of the agent program is going to work. This is a basic diagram. The components is divided into three types. Atomic, it is going to communicate by atomic, that means one-to-one, or by factored and by structured. Now we can place the representation along the axis of increasing complexity and expensive power. It can be atomic, factored or structured. Now to illustrate these ideas, it helps to consider a particular agent component such as the one that deals with what my actions do. This component describes the changes that might occur in the environment as a result of taking an action. In atomic representation, each state of the world is indivisible. It has no internal structure. Consider the problem of dividing a driving route from one end of a country to the other via some sequence of cities. For the purpose of solving this problem, it may suffice to reduce the state of the world to just the name of the city we are going in, a single atomic knowledge, a black box whose only discernible property is that of being identical to or different from the other black box. So here the black box means the internal representation or internal structure is not aware. Only the task is given, and that subtask is it has no matter of what the subtask is. It has given only the task and it is going to complete the task. So that is known as atomic representation. That means it has no internal structure. For example, suppose we are writing any function, and for that function the output we have already defined. Now how it doesn't matter how the function has been written, but the matters what is the input and what is the output. So for example, suppose I make the program for the addition of the two numbers, and we have given the two inputs and I'm expecting one output. If I'm getting a proper or correct result, then it is atomic representation, but it is not aware of any internal structure, means how the addition is done, it is not aware of that internal structure. The algorithm underlying search and the game playing, hidden Markov models and Markov decisions process, these all are atomic representation. Suppose you are searching a particular name or a particular value, that will be the atomic representation, or in the game playing also, that will be the atomic representation. A factor representation, that is split of each state into fixed set of variables or attributes, each of which can have a value. Means here the state or here the task has a particular subtask, or it is split into each state, and that particular each state has a variables and attributes. Next, that is structured representation, in which the object such as cows or trucks and their various or varying relationships can be represented explicitly. It means a particular state is dependent on another state, and if there is any relational between the states, that is called as structural representation. So the examples are first order logic or knowledge based learning or natural language understanding. These are the structural representation. Now the axis along which the atomic factor or structural representation lie is the axis of increasing expensive. The more expressive representation can capture at least as concisely everything a less expensive one can capture, plus some more. Often the more expensive languages is much more concise. For example, the rules of chess can be written in a page or two of the structured representation language such as first order logic, but requires thousands of pages when written in a factored representation language such as propositional logic. On the other hand, the reasoning and learning becomes more complex as the expensive power of the representation increases. to gain the benefit of expensive representation while avoiding their drawbacks. Intelligent system for the real world may need to operate at all the points along the axis simultaneously. So this was the end of the chapter. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. We are going to talk on the object question on this chapter also. So when we solve the object questions, you will come to know better about this chapter. So this was end of the chapter. If you have any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.